a democratic right to have a proper media and to have competitive media. And I think, you know, to see the number of journalists who've turned up today is testament to that. It can happen to anybody tomorrow if we don't band together and fight to save jobs. And that's basically what this is about today. And I'm delighted to see particularly members of the print and journalist fraternity here. I think it's extremely important that they remain behind this, because it's today it's the Longford News, tomorrow it's some other newspaper, and it's time for people to stand up for what they believe.
Well, we've lost 9 jobs for start-offs. The manner in which the jobs were lost is appalling. You had young professional people turning up for work to be told, we'll put the paper out today, but then your jobs are gone. That's no way to conduct business. I mean, you know, it's 9 jobs in Longford, that's the equivalent of 900 jobs in Dublin. We're a small town, we can't take it.
I just came down on my lunch break to support us, and I think it's wrong. It's a big turnout for Longford.
We're here today to support our colleagues who are been supported by their many friends who we see gathered here today. We think it's very important as the NUJ National Executive to support our colleagues at this time, and we certainly think that the support they've got today, they will be very pleased with, and it's great encouragement for them. And necessity in the area for extra press and an extra voice, and we certainly feel that the Longford News can be made a viable issue once again.
I'm here today supporting my NUJ colleagues as well, but I'm also supporting another Longford business that's closing, which is terrible to see. And I think the role of the News, as the second paper in Longford, has been well established. It's not some fly-by-night paper that was set up to take advantage of the Celtic Tiger. This is a paper that's really an institution in Longford, as much as a landmark as a Longford leader over the years. And I think that's why a lot of people are particularly disappointed to see it closed, and in this fashion, and to see its staff, who are part of the local community here, out of jobs this week, is really very, very sad. But it's always great to see people supporting the local media. It's interesting the times they choose to come out to do so, but it is brilliant to see people coming out in support of the Longford News.
Very much established in the community, a lot of great history to it, the great characters down the years worked there. Albert Reynolds is a former owner of this place. Yeah. So, you know, there's a lot of history here, and you know, it's one of those things you don't know what you've lost until you lose it.
It's no more, you know, because it's only here a football show in Longford, because our food in the tier, Con Rokina, Con Rokinish. His popper is Sugar Fader, a Kamad, is a Kahu, Kumas.
We just cannot sit back and allow it to go. Like, we need the Longford News, we need 2 papers in Longford. The Longford leader, the best of luck to them, but I remember, I'm a lot older than most of those people here, when the first owner of the Longford News, the man who brought it in 75 years ago, Vincent Gill, and when he ran a business with 2 and 3 people for the Alpha Group, to come along now, overnight, and tell 9 people that they no longer are employed, I think is a scandal. They're not thinking about people, they're not thinking about people's rights.
It's not your basic right as a human being to stand up and protest. If you think someone is being walked over and used like that, I think you should stand up. And if you don't, then you should have no voice to say, given that what people have got to tap into other people like that. If you don't stand up for your own community, what's going to happen?